Welcome to Salesforce Taylor's Python video series. Let me introduce myself. I'm from the Salesforce Taylor's team, having a 4 year of experience in the Python language. If you really want to learn Python in depth, so please follow my complete Python video series till end. Okay. So let's start with my first lecture about an introduction of Python. So if you want to get more information about Python, so you can also switch to our website. The website name is salesforcedealers.com. Okay. We open the web browser, press the salesforcedealers.com at the URL area and press the enter. After that, you will be see this following page and go into learn Python section. So here, first is the programming overview. It's mean an introduction of the Python. So Python programming is the powerful, expressive, productive at the same time. With the Python, we can create a quick programming and in an understandable form. We don't need to write a full code in the Python because it provides a huge collection of libraries. So if you want to know about the feature of the Python, so Python supports the high level language, it's the closest to human. And second thing is that it is the open source language. Python is easy, lots of complex of syntax is moved. It's a highly readable language. It is reduced the length of the code and makes code is too easy. Python depend upon the interpreter. So you here you can get the all information about the introduction of the Python. So here is that. First is that Python is a high level language. Okay, it's a high level. So how many type of language is there? Is a low level language first? Low level language. The second is a high level language. Okay. Low level language is related to the machine code as a 0 1 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 0 0. Okay, it is a form in a low level language, but in the case of high level language support natural language. What's a natural language? Natural language are those language we are using in a daily life, like English, Hindi, and French, Chinese, Japanese is the natural language of the human. So high level language is support a natural language, and low level language is supported by our computer. Okay. So if we are writing a program in the high level language, that their language translator exists, that it is converting the high level language into the low level language. So let's see what is a language translator. So here is a language okay here is a language translator. So first is that interpreter, a second is a compiler. Okay, so interpreter and compiler both are the language translator. Okay. So here is a different working of the interpreter and compiler. Here is the interpreter is supported by the Python, compiler is supported by the C language. Java support the interpreter, compiler both are. Okay, so what is the interpreter do? Interpreter do is that it's the part of language translators. It's obviously that it is a converting the high level language into the low level language, and other it is a converting the low level language to high level language. It's mean it is a working as a mediator. Interpreter know the high level and low level both language. It is a converting HLL to LLM, LLL to HLL. Okay. So what is the difference between the compiler and interpreter? That's the interpreter. it is a convert code line by line. It means that first this, let's assume that the this line will be executed in low level language, then again it will convert this this line in into the low level, again this line, third line, and again this line. It means that the interpreter is convert code line by line. It's converting into the high level to low level language in the line by line. So in the case of compiler, that compiler, it is convert whole line, whole code into machine line, machine code. Okay, it means that it will take the all the code and it will take the all the code and it will convert into the machine language. Okay, so if you are talking the velocity of this interpreter and compiler, the here is the compiler is the fastest rather than the interpreter. Okay, the compiler is the fast because it's taking the all the code and converting to the low level language. It means the machine code. Okay, but interpreter, the case of interpreter, it's taking the one by one and converting to the machine code. So here is the compiler is the fast rather than the interpreter. So let's see the general information about the Python. The Python developed by Guido van Rossum. Okay, it's a developed by the Guido van Rossum in 1991. Basically, it's a late 1991. Okay. Basically, it is developed in 1988, but it's not coming on the official version. So, officially, it is released at the 1991. When it is a, firstly, Python is a developed on. The module of the Python is developed on the C. So that is at that time it's called the Cython. It's not a Python at that time because it's a development C language, so it's called the Cython. So again, it's the module of the Python is a developed in the Java. So Java is Python. It's become a Jython. Then again, Python is developed into itself. Then finally, Python name is given to this language. After the Python module itself introduced in the Python. Okay, the module is working. Then Python is a collection of the huge amount of the inbuilt library. If we use the inbuilt library, we do not have to use and write the full code of the any code. We have to use the library of inbuilt library of the Python. It make the code more easy rather than the other languages. So guys, why I am using the Python. If there is a lot of languages available in the market like Java, C++, and C#, so why we are use the Python? So Python is basically, it's using that. Why? It's very easy. Let's see. I'm giving the code. So guys, don't understand the code, I will be discussing the later. Just you see that. How did we working? See, I will be guide you the full installation of the Python. I will guide you the all the syntax of the Python. So don't worry about it. It's a demonstration of the why the Python is preferred. So don't worry about it. So here you can see that there is no header file required to add it in the Python. So to use the Python language, here I am taking the 85 plus 9455. It's when I pressing the enter, it's given the addition of this number. So I will give you the another numbers that, so it's given the another number. So that's why you can see that here is the very easy. Suppose I'm defining any array, basically it is the list in the Python. So if I want to sum up, I want to sum up this number of this array, you can take this. If you want to know the maximum number of this array, you can do 2345 the maximum number. What is the minimum number of this array? It's that is a 5 is the minimum number. If you want to sort this array, you can sort using the sort function and printing it. So you can see that is the sorting. If you want to reverse sort this number, okay, you can also just reverse sort of this number that. I'm printing A right now. So you can see that it's very easy. Just given the one line code for the reverse sorting. So that is why Python is too easy to write anything. You see, so we are preferring the Python because there is lots of inbuilt module. Inbuilt modules provided by the Python with the help of inbuilt module. We can use. We don't write to return the full code in the language. So that's why we are choosing the Python. So here is a basic brief knowledge about the Python. So I hope you guys understand what is the Python, how to use it, what is the interpreter, and what is the compiler. It is the basic information about the Python. So I hope you enjoy this video, love this video. So thanks for my watching video. Thank you guys.